than the eye could see. I don't deserve his love, but he's always been there for me. You see, Jesus met me when I was at my lowest. And if you don't know Jesus, know this. He is the greatest example of generosity this world of greed has ever seen. And when Jesus hit the scene, he changed the scenery and met diversity with serenity. If you're looking for peace, he offers plenty. Jesus was and Jesus will forever be king. And when the angels sing, they sing of the grace that was displayed for sinners like me. I can't explain him and I can't describe him. And if I could, he wouldn't be Jesus, because you can't explain eternity and you can't comprehend the galaxies, but it was the loving hands of Jesus who spun them into existence and created man. And knowing he would go to the cross to pay our sentence. There was a certificate of judgment with a period after the sentence, and we were sentenced to death long before he said, "It is finished." He is a father to the orphan, a shelter for the homeless, a hiding place for the abused, and an anchor for our storms. He stormed the gates of hell and came out on top, and the power of his gospel cannot be stopped, even when the world tries. They try a lot. He traded places with Barabbas and became the catalyst of missions across the world, covering every portion of the Atlas. If you're in need of rest, I know of a mattress. If you don't know Jesus, your future is tragic, but he gladly embraced tragedy so we could live in his presence of majesty. His presence is presence, and it's his presence that presents preciousness to a world of peasants. He is far from pretentious, but still loves those who are. He is the light of the world and hung the stars. He brings the dead to life and delivers life to the dead. He took a crown of thorns on his head so we could put crowns at his feet, and I can't wait until I get to kiss his feet that were nailed to a cross for me and for you and for every person around the world. He loves the world, and I love his word, because the word became flesh, and in his flesh he demonstrated the word to the world. He is an example to every boy and every girl. He is a lover of black people. He is a lover of white people. He is a lover of the unchurched and the assembly under the steeple. He doesn't see the believers' failures, but still takes time to celebrate their faithfulness. It's the power of the Spirit that enables us and gives us boldness when the world labels us. And if you want to label me, please call me a Jesus freak. If that freaks you out, good, because it's better to be good with God than to fight being misunderstood by a world that could never understand. So let it be understood that I don't worship man, we worship Jesus. And although he doesn't need us, he still sees us and pleads with us to run to the cross where he bled for us. His heart bleeds for us, his heart grieves for us, but still graciously grants us a pardon for our treason in a season where the world tries to explain away the work of the Spirit with human reasoning. There is a reason they can't. Because the Spirit is like the wind, and the wind cannot be seen. But loved is the one who believes without seeing the unseen. I'm telling you today that Jesus is something. He's something more. He's something great. And if you want to know him, you don't have to wait. He stands at the narrow path with a key to the gate, and you only have to reach out and embrace his grace. I don't care who's president. I have a king who is always present. I don't care who holds musical celebrity. The voice of the Lord will always be the sweetest melody. I don't care who owns the riches of the globe. My Jesus holds more wealth than one ruby on his robe. I don't care who is the strongest or the fastest. Nothing matches the creator of the universe and his immortal, infinite status. I don't care about religious leaders who died and stayed dead. I'll only worship the one who conquered death and wears a crown on his head. His name is Jesus, and I'm telling you, he's something. He was faithful yesterday, and he is faithful today. I can feel his presence whenever I pray, and when the time comes for me to fade away, I'll remember the day I heard him say, "My name is Jesus."
Thank you. Come on, someone say, "His name is Jesus." Let's all stand this beautiful Sunday morning and tell your neighbor, get ready for a miracle. Come on. Tell someone else, get ready, because it's here now. Hallelujah. God is great, greatly to be praised. Welcome to Living Faith Family Worship Church. Shake somebody's hand and just tell them God's love is here. Hallelujah. Shake someone else's hand and tell them his love is for you. Come on. Our vision here at church is to always have faith, always operate through love, and always claim the victory of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. It's Family Communion Sunday. We've all come to gather at the Lord's table and to bless his holy name. We're also here to give praises to our Heavenly Father. We're also here to lift up, as you just heard, the name that's bigger than any name. And his name is, church, Jesus. Say it again. His name is Jesus. That's right. So grab the hand of the person next to you right now as we pray and lift up his name. Father, we thank you, Lord, for what you're doing. Lord, what you continue to do. Happy birthday, Jesus. Happy birthday, Jesus. We celebrate. The mic is good. We celebrate Lord, the goodness of God. We celebrate the awesome mercy of God. We celebrate the power of God. And we celebrate His grace in our lives today. We declare that here at Living Faith, miracles will follow the families. We declare here at Living Faith, grace is sufficient. We declare here at Living Faith, you answer our prayers. For the prayers of a righteous man availeth much. And I declare that as we have come to your house with our needs, we've come to this house to celebrate the King. We declare in Jesus' name that every person in this place, their need will be met in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen. Amen. Someone say, Lewis, I call you blessed. Lewis, say, Pastor Lewis, I call you blessed. He's changed this world through his music and his love, but he's also discipled worshipers. Amen. So why don't you give our wonderful praise team a great hand clap as we celebrate the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Let's put our hands together.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive our King. Let every heart prepare Him a room,
and heaven and nature see.
Amen. We worship you, Jesus. Sing with us. He rules the world.
He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glory of His righteousness and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders, and wonders of His love.
Amen. Sing it again. Joy to the world.
Joy to the world. The Savior reigns. Let men their song.
Joy to the world.
Joy to the world.
The Savior.
The Savior reigns.
Let men their songs employ.
Wild fields and floods. Rock hills and bays. Repeat the sounding joy. Repeat the sounding joy.
Everybody, come on, let's put your hands together like this. Come on. Come on, everybody, let's sing the song like this.
Nothing can separate, even if I ran away. Your love
never fails.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know I still make mistakes, but you have new mercies for me every day. Your love never fails.
You stay the same. Come on.
You stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes in the morning. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love.
Come on, church, say it. Your love never fails.
Whoa, oh, whoa, oh, oh, oh. 'Cause your love never fails. Whoa, oh, 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 oh.
Wind is strong.
The wind is strong and the water's deep. But I'm not alone here in these open seas. Your love never fails.
Thank you, Jesus. We love you, Father.
This chasm is far too wide. I never thought I'd reach the other side. 'Cause your love never fails.
You stay the same. Come on. Come on, church.
'Cause you stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes in the morning. When the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. Your love never
you stay the same, 'cause
you stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes with the morning.
Woo!
And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. Your love never fails. Whoa, oh, whoa, oh, oh, oh. 'Cause your love never fails. Whoa, oh, 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 oh.
'Cause you make
all things work together for my good.
Somebody lift their hands and receive that.
You make all things work together for my good.
We lift our hands, Father, to you, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We lift our hands, Father, and we receive, Lord God. We receive your word, Lord God.
You make all things work together for my good.
Come on, church.
You make all things work together for my good. 'Cause you make all things work together for my good.
Come on, church, sing it.
'Cause you make all things work together for my good.
Come on.
'Cause you make all things work together for my good.
You stay the same. Lift them up.
You stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes with the morning.
Woo!
And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. Your love never fails. 'Cause you stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes with the morning. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. Your love never fails. Whoa, oh, whoa, oh, 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 oh. 'Cause your love never fails. Whoa, oh, 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 whoa, oh, oh, oh. 'Cause you make all things work together for my good.
Thank you, Father. We love you. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Work together for my good. 'Cause you make all things work together for my good. You make all things work together for my good. 'Cause you make all things work together for my good.
Come on, church, lift your hands.
Make all things work together for my good. 'Cause you make all things work together for my good. You make all things work together for my good.
Such a peace and such a blessing here in this house this morning. And the Bible says in Romans chapter 8, starting with verse 28, and we know, it's not and we're trying to figure it out, it's not and I think, it's not and I may, it's and we know. Someone say, I know. Yeah, and we know that all things work together for good to those who love God. Who does it work together for? To those who love God. Someone say, I love you, Jesus. The Bible says, and we know. Say, and I know. All things, say, all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. And the power of God is in this place right now because there is purpose in this house. Amen. How do I know that there's purpose? Keep that going, Eloy or Sebastian. How do I know that there's purpose in this house? Well, because there's people. Look around this house. Come on, it's filled up. It's filled up. There's people in this house. Amen. That's why there's purpose. Amen. In this house. Yes. Come on, where there is purpose, there is vision. Yes, and where there is vision, there's no lack. Come on. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, and there's no perishing. There's only blessings. Come on. There's only blessings. Amen. He said, build and I'll bless. He said, build and I'll bless. Whew. What a blessing. What a blessing. Hallelujah. Father, we honor you and we worship you. And we thank you, Lord, for what you're doing right now in the name of Jesus. I want us to have our chairs right now and be seated. I want those that are helping us with our offering elements of our Lord's table to come forward, please. Hallelujah. We're going to be distributing this blessing of the elements. And we encourage everyone to receive of the Lord's table. It's very important as men and women, as children of God, that we obey what God has said for us to do. And he said, Jesus said, do this remembering me. And so that's why we do it, because we remember Jesus, his life, his love, and his continual reign in our lives. So we're going to sing a slow worship song, very gentle. And then we're going to pass them out to each and every family member. And then we'll partake together. Amen. So receive right now. I call this time blessed, that we offer our love to you in the name of Jesus, remembering who you are and what you have done for us. God bless you as you receive at the Lord's table. Amen.
nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare your longing home. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen of the goodness of love's. When my heart becomes free and my shame is undone, oh, your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Presence, Lord. Lord, your presence, Lord.
There's nothing worth more.
So obediently, received to the Lord's table. He called his disciples, Matthew 26 and 26. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and he blessed and he broke it and he gave it to them. And he said, "Take, eat, this is my body." And then he took the cup and he gave it to them and he thanked and he gave it. Then to them saying, "Drink, this is mine, this is my blood." And this is my new covenant for you, and it's shed for the remission of sins. We can break the body and declare that our body is whole and well. So do that right now. And I declare healing in our midst right now because we have received from the Lord. Now, with your same manner, just pick up the cup. And he said, take this. This is the offering of my blood and sacrifice, and this is the new covenant. The new covenant that there's no longer needs to be a sacrifice of ram, bull, goats. But he was the ultimate sacrifice. And because he sacrificed his life, we live today and have an eternal home. Our sins are forgiven by his blood. In Jesus' name, please take and receive right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And thank you, Holy Spirit. Someone say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
And thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Say it again. Say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
And thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you to the praise team. You may be seated at this time. What a blessing in the house of God as we together love on Jesus, amen. Remembering the power of his life, the blessing of his death, oh, the victory of his resurrection, come on, and the celebration of the gift of God. Come on. Someone say, King Jesus, he's coming back, amen. That's right. What a blessing. Pastor Kim's coming to take a portion of the service and to bless you. Let's give her a great hand clap. Amen. What a blessing. What a blessing. What a blessing.
Thank you, Pastor Mark. Well, can you believe it's already December? Wow. This year really went by fast. And you know, we have a lot of exciting things going on. And we, Pastor Mark, every week I ask, can we tell him yet? Can we tell him yet? And he says, not yet, not yet. I got to cover a few things, not yet. But he said, go ahead, tell the church. So, you know, before I get to our fun announcement, let me just give a few. December 23rd. Everybody say December 23rd. That's the Wednesday before Christmas Eve. We're going to be having our Christmas banquet theater here at the church. And we're going to have tables set out. And we're just going to have a beautiful food fellowship here and music. And I've asked some people to minister. And I'm going to ask some more people to sing and do specials. And so if that's you and you want to sing, Sister Odalia, y'all go ahead and let me know and be ready to sing. Amen. So it's going to be a beautiful a Wednesday night service. So if you can be with us, be with us. We have room this year for more tables. I remember last year I told Pastor Mark, I said, you know, it's Christmas Eve, so a lot of people will probably be out of town. So, you know, we should have plenty of room for everybody. It should be fine. We should have plenty of food. Well, we ended up with standing room only and going to buy chicken. So this year we're going to be ready. And some of you ladies, if you want to help with the menu, we're going to keep it simple this year because we had Thanksgiving, and we're going to do some good carne guisada and rice and beans. So I've already had some ladies asking to help serve and men too and cook. So if you want to jump in and jump in the boat, we'll take the help. Amen. Tonight also we're going to have our Spanish service at 6 p.m. And that's one of the things I wanted to talk to y'all about today. Starting 2016, immediately in 2016, that's just about 3 weeks away, Mark and I have had it in our heart to continue with our Spanish service and to be able to have it more. And a lot of people have wanted to do more and reach out more to our Spanish speaking community. And one thing that we understand about South Texas and Cotulla, a lot of people understand English, but they prefer Spanish, and most everybody who speaks Spanish understands English. So starting in 2016, Every Sunday morning at 9:30, we're going to be having a bilingual service. It's going to be a full service with Spanish music, and that's going to be every Sunday and with words. So it's going to be a full service at 9:30, and then we're going to have another full service at 10:45. Amen? So we're excited about that. And you know, for some of y'all might want to come to the early service because you prefer to be at an earlier service. Some of y'all might stay for two, and I know some of you mamas, it's a little easier to come at 10:45 when we get all of our babies dressed. So it's a blessing. We're excited. So starting 2016, we're not going to have a once a month Spanish service. We're going to have it every Sunday, and it's going to be awesome. And we're excited. So we're ready to go. We're going to keep trunking. And you know, this year we also started and launched our young adults ministry, and it's going well. And everybody say more. We want to do more. So starting also in 2016, we are going to start having weekly youth services. And that's for our youth and preteens. I know a lot of y'all have asked us. So starting in 2016, we're going to have weekly youth services. And y'all know that when Pastor Mark ministers, it's very relevant. It's very easy to understand. But we want our young people to be able to enjoy each other's fellowship, to all be together and gather in one place. So right now, we're still figuring out details. What room are they going to use? Is it going to be on a Wednesday and them take a... they can even go to our house, you know, all be together. But we want them to start enjoying and sharpening each other as youth. So we're excited to make that announcement for 2016. And, you know, every year for the past 3 years, we've pushed forward. We're doing a little more. We're thinking outside the box. We're pushing even though we don't know how we're going to do it, you know. But God is supernaturally making things happen. You know, Pastor Mark announced, you know, we want to do some concrete. We want to lay concrete. And I'm like, okay, you know, here's another project. And supernaturally, men started coming, material started coming, concrete trucks are coming tomorrow. By faith, we did it. So praise God, ladies, we don't have to break our heels anymore trying to walk on the caliches. So a little at a time, that concrete is coming in. And God is just moving, and God is certainly working miracles. And I have a fun announcement right now. Now, let me finish the announcement before you get too excited, okay? So, all of y'all know I love babies. I love children. If you have babies, I always go and I take your babies and I love on your babies. You know, and I always told Mark, if I could have another baby, I would have another baby. And I was all excited. He's like, oh, Lord, I rebuked that. We have enough babies. So I got a gift. Even better, well, I call it a gift for me, but it's kind of for me, but not really. But I just wanted to give a fun announcement that I'm super excited about. You know, Tiffany and Eloy got married several months ago, and we're proud to announce that they have a baby coming in August. So I'm excited. We get to be Nana Kim, and Tiff's excited. You know, they've waited, and God's blessing them. So we just want to keep them in prayer. And ladies, y'all surround her and check on her. She's been feeling good. You know, she's been a trooper. You know, doctor's appointments coming up. So y'all stay close to them for their first baby, and be excited with us. Amen? Amen. We're growing one baby at a time. Amen. Let me read you a scripture. Out of Matthew 28, it says, then Jesus came to them. This is the last thing he said. He said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey all my commandments. For surely I am with you to the very end of the age. You know, I was reading that this morning, and I was telling, Lord, I'm going to serve you. You know, we're living in a time today where we have no choice but to serve Jesus. We have no choice but to follow Jesus. The devil is on a rampage. He's trying to steal our joy. He's trying to steal our family. And, you know, more than ever, we have to stay together. We have to link together. But even more than that, we have to spread the gospel. because there's a lost and hurting world out there that needs what we have. You can't just depend on Mark and Kim to do everything. We need you to spread the gospel, to reach out to others, to touch people's lives, to give them a hug. You know, there's people in here that have had to make a choice even to get up this morning because it hurt too much to get up for everything that they were going through. But there's people in here that have reached out to them and have helped them get up in the morning, have helped them wipe their tears and said, you know what, there is hope. God will give you supernatural peace. And we have to keep pushing that way. You know, right now there's people that have had to make a choice that they're not going to follow man, but they're going to follow God. And sometimes following God, it can be almost challenging because you might have to say goodbye to somebody and move on to another level, but God directs your path. God gives you that supernatural peace. You know, and in saying that, I want Pastor Mark to come. We're going to bless a family. You know, they've had to make a decision to follow God and to follow vision, to follow destiny. They want to do so much for God. And we bless all of our churches, but we want to bless Fernando and Criselda and the entire family. If they could come up here. They've made a decision to join us here and to serve the vision here at Living Faith. Let's give them a hand clap. And we love and support the decision that they've made. The decision that they've made to follow God. And church, you say, we receive. Hallelujah. Amen. Pastor Mark.
Hallelujah. Just have them line up right here. Line up facing the altar area. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to ask my associates, mom and dad, to please come at this time. Lewis is standing in faith with us all. I'm going to ask Brother Chavel and Sister Rani to please come as well. Sister Elia to please come. Tommy, I'm going to ask you to come and stand as well with this family. What a blessing, church. Someone say, we're blessed. Say it again. Say, we're blessed. Hallelujah. We are a blessed church. To have families unite and come and say yes to Jesus. Now, each and every one of you know the wonderful Gonzalez family and their love for the Lord Jesus Christ. They're no stranger in the ministry. They've been in ministry. They love ministry. They love music. Come on. They love what they do for the Lord. And so, church, I'm telling everybody, get ready. Come on. We are blessed to have this family here with us. And as family and as believers, we've come in agreement to anoint them. Here, Dad, I want you to grab the oil and I want you to take this to each person there. And I want you to begin to anoint them and pray over them right now. And church, you're there seated. I want you to stretch your hand right now. For the Gonzalez family, just lift your hands because you are being anointed of the Lord. And the Lord would say unto thee, my ways and greater days. He would say unto thee, my ways and greater days. So I declare in the name of Jesus that as you walk by faith and not by sight, I declare that by the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that everything you do, it is unto the Lord. I call you the head. Come on, church, and not the tail. I call you above. Come on, church, help me preach, and never beneath. I declare you're blessed coming in and you're blessed going out. I declare that wherever you put your hand to, it shall prosper and shall be blessed in the name of Jesus. Now, church, why don't we say we receive them in the name of Jesus? Come on, say it again. Say we receive them in the name of Jesus. What a blessing, what a blessing, what a blessing. Hallelujah and hallelujah. What a blessing, what a blessing. Well, what's going on, Pastor? I'm having prayer warriors, just anoint them. I'm having some of our church members that began with us. Now, well, I began with you, I know, but you're coming again. It's all good, it's all good. Hallelujah. I'm just blessing them. I'm just blessing them. I'm just blessing them. Thank you, Jesus. Now, Eli and Lily, y'all were with us. I want you to get the anointing and anoint all their feet right now and just pray over their feet. I declare their steps are ordered. I declare their steps are ordered. So, Pastor, what's going on because they're anointed? Well, there's a greater call upon their life. Come on. Somebody say, greater is he. Come on. Say, greater is he that is in me. Come on. Than he that is in the world. Hallelujah. There's going to be some challenges. I'm going to tell you right now, Fernando. I'm going to tell you right now, Criselda. There's going to be some challenges that will knock at your door. There's going to be some challenges that are going to knock at your door. But greater is he that is in you. Come on. Someone say with Pastor, greater is he. Greater is he. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. And I release them by faith to walk by faith. To know his love and to understand the greatest victory there is with your saving grace. So I bless the Gonzalez family and I thank you, Lord God, for that word given to them. Hallelujah. Higher ways and God-given days. Glory to God. I declare them just in more in love with Jesus than ever. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. And the church says amen. The church says, so be it. Now, I want some people to come, some of the Abigail Ministry, Master's Commission. Come on. Y'all get on up here and hug on them. Now, Criselda, I'm going to put you on the spot. Come up here. I want you to say a word of love. Come on, Criselda. Come on up here and just, I want you to say a word of love and just greet the people. Just greet the people. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Pastor, get on with the church service. This is the service. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. Please share your heart.
God bless you. It's a blessing to be here this morning, gathered with my family and all of y'all as my church family. We're just happy and just grateful, you know, to be here and to be a part of this church. I didn't prepare the song, but thank you so much.
You got it. Come on, give them a great hand clap. Amen. They are so loved and they are just so welcomed. What a blessing, what a blessing, what a blessing. I want to pray for all the children. Hallelujah. We're going to pray for all the children. Hallelujah. Come on, children. Come on up here. All the students. Then I'm going to be saying, let all the young people come up here too. Because we're going to be praying all the young people. So it's going to be great. We're going to have to fill all these chairs up. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. They're filling up. Hallelujah. They look wonderful. All the blessings of the Lord. Someone say they're blessed. They're blessed. Someone say they're blessed. Hallelujah and hallelujah. All right, let's pray and bless them right now. Come on, children. Let's lift our hands. Father, we bless you with our gifts and our children. And we thank you, Lord, for their lives and their love for you. We thank you for the teachers and what you're doing in their classrooms, Lord, teaching them, training them, molding them. And I call them blessed in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen and amen. All right, let's go ahead and march on to our classrooms. Danny, if you can escort them, help them with all the construction that's going on right now. It's important that we just be alert right now where we are. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Marky, move that fan. It's hitting the mic and it's sounding like a mighty rushing wind of just blessings. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, church, we're getting sidewalks. Someone say amen. Amen. Come on, church. We're getting some sidewalks. Thank you, Jesus. You know, the Lord is building his house. And more than just construction work in the house of God, but also building in our house. Just touch the temple of the Lord right here. We are the temple of the Lord. You are the house of the Lord. And as we, and I love this because the moment we began to break sheetrock here, and many of the brethren that came and helped and many that continue to help and pray and sow seeds and continue to give love, you know, you are a part of that. And the moment we began to break ground and just continue to build, you know what takes place when we do some construction outwardly? God is doing some construction inwardly. Amen. And I know that he's doing some things eternally inwardly in the lives of our church. And as the faith continues to grow, as the momentum continues to grow, you begin to see exteriorly the blessings of the Lord. And if you see them exteriorly, come on, outwardly, you know on the inside, blessings are here. Amen. You know miracles are here. You see, before anybody ever received a tangible outward miracle, they had to believe first by faith on the inside. They had to believe by faith on the inside. There was a lame man at the gate Beautiful in Acts chapter 3. Don't go there. That's not a part of the message this morning, but it goes with what I'm saying. And it was a beautiful gate. And that beggar was there for many years. He was always brought there. And his duty, life, was to beg. As people came into the house, he was there begging. Well, you know the story. After the resurrection of Jesus Christ, and Pastor Kim read the beautiful scripture about Jesus Christ saying, "All authority I have given to you." Well, here comes two crazy 2x2 disciples. Come on. Here comes some fishermen. Come on. Here comes some Living Faith members. Come on, somebody. Here comes some radical on fire for God people. Come on. And they're going to pray. They're going to the house of the Lord to pray. And before they reach the house, they are confronted by a need, a person. And this person begins to say alms. He begins to beg for money, for something, because he can't work. He's a cripple. He can't do for himself. And so Peter and John, as they're going to the temple, they see him and he sees them. And the Bible says that Peter says, "Look at us." Wait a minute. He was already looking at. He knew they were coming. He knew they were men of God. And surely every man of God has a tender heart from the Lord. Surely every man of God would have something to give for the poor. Come on. For the handicap, for the disease, come on. Surely these men who honor the house of God will have something to give me. So he was already looking at them. But Peter said, "Look at us." In other words, he said, don't look at us exteriorly. Look it on the inside. In other words, don't just see what's going to happen right now on the outside, but look what's fixing to happen on the inside. And he said, "Silver and gold I have none, but what I do have," someone say his name is Jesus. He said, "Silver and gold I have not, but what I do have, I give it to you." And he said, "Get up and walk in the name of Jesus of Nazareth," and got him by the right hand with that authority and picked him up. Come on. 40 years he had been lame, begging on the side of the gate called Beautiful. Many years suffering, but yet that day was a day of change because God did something on the inside. And just like what God is doing on the inside of this church, it is a demonstration of what God can do also on the outside. We've been believing God and continuing to believe God for sacrificial praises, sacrificial offerings, sacrificial gifts and time and talent and treasure to flood the house of God so that his kingdom would continue to stand strong. Amen. Amen. And the blessing of the Lord is upon this house. And I don't say that just because God has graced me with the call to pastor this church, but I say that because he has said it. And for those that receive it shall be blessed. Amen. So just say, I receive in the name of Jesus. That's right. Tell your neighbor, come on, let's jump in the boat. Hallelujah. Come on, let's get on board. You hear it? Choo-choo. The train is moving. Come on, we got to get on board. Amen. What a blessing. What a blessing. I see Sister B and Sister Benny here, and oh, what a blessing. Now, they've made a beautiful transition to the great, great, great city of San Antonio. Come on, give them a great hand clap. Amen. Of love. What a blessing to have the family of God travel and even so be a part of the vision of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Someone say, we call the Ramon family blessed. In the name of Jesus, we declare 2015. Come on, help me. We declare 2015 a harvest year. Come on. We declare 2016. Come on. A supernatural year. Come on. Someone say, to God be the glory. Someone say it again, to God be the glory. We are so blessed to have families that are committed to the Lord Jesus Christ and will be obedient to the voice of God. And that's us today. Amen. What a blessing. I want to bring a message this morning to each and every one of us that it's going to awaken some things in our lives. It's going to help us. It's going to guide us. It's going to give us love. It's going to assure us. And it's going to confirm some things. It's going to convict some areas in our lives. And it's going to move us to love and live more for Jesus. Someone say, love and live more. That's it. Love and live more for Jesus. Father, as we partake of your word this morning, Lord, we know that it is your word that changes everything. We know, Father, because of your word, Father, we are saved and set free today. It is your word that became flesh and it dwelt among men. It is your word that carries us. It is your word that will never fade or never be broken. We thank you for the living word in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen. Amen. This message is titled, Clean Hands or Clean Hearts. Say it with Pastor, clean hands or clean hearts. That's a question we have today. That's a question we must live today. Are my hands clean? Is my heart clean? Am I so focused on keeping my hands clean that I really neglect to clean my heart? We've been studying the book of Mark for quite some time, and it's been such a blessing to hear just what God is doing through the book of Mark, in the book of Mark, even in this church. And we've been studying in Mark chapter 6, and we've graduated to Mark chapter 7. Someone say, thank you, Jesus. Amen. Let's read Mark chapter 7. It's on the screen. If you have your Bible, let's turn there, please, to Mark chapter 7. Then the Pharisees and some of the scribes, they all came together to him, having come from Jerusalem. Now when they saw some of his disciples and ate bread with defiled, that is, with unwashed hands, they found fault. For the Pharisees and the Jews did not eat unless they washed their hands in a special way, holding the tradition of the elders. When they come from the marketplace, they do not eat unless they wash. And there are many other things which they have received and hold, like the washing of cups, pitchers, copper vessels, couches. Then the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, why do your disciples not wash according to the tradition of the elders, but eat bread with unwashed hands? He answers and he says to them, verse 6, well, did Isaiah prophesy of you hypocrites, as it is written, this people honors me with their lips, but their hearts is far from me. And in vain they worship me, teaching as doctrines the commandments of men. For laying aside the commandments of God and hold the tradition of men, the washing of the pitchers and cups and many others, such they do. He said to them, all too well, you reject the commandment of God, but you may keep your traditions. For Moses said, honor your father and your mother, and he who curses father or mother, let him be put to death. Verse 11, but you say, if a man says to his father or mother, whatever profit you might have received from me in carbon, that is a gift to God, that you no longer let him to anything for his father or his mother, making the word of God to no effect through your tradition which you have handed down, and may such things you do. When he had called all the multitude, verse 14, and he said to himself, and he said to them, hear me and hear me well. He said, understand these words. There is nothing that enters a man from the outside which can defile him, but the things which come out of him, those are the things that define or defile a man. If anyone has ears to hear, let him hear. And so when he entered the house away from the crowd, his disciples asked him concerning this parable. So he said to them, are you thus without understanding also? Do you not perceive? Outside cannot defile him, but because it enters in his heart, but in his stomach, and it is eliminated, thus purifying all foods. And he said, what comes out of a man, that is what defiles a man. For from within, out of the heart of men, proceed evil thoughts, adulterers, fornication, murderers, thefts, covetousness, wickedness, deceit, lewdness, evil eye, blasphemies, pride, foolishness. All these evil things come from within and defile a man. It is what comes out that will defile a man. This word, hypocrisy, this word, hypocrite, is used a lot in our world today. I've met people that have told me when we've prayed for them and ministered to them, well, I don't go to church because there's so many hypocrites in church. They're hallelujah and on Sunday, but then on Monday, might as well be defined as the devil. So I don't go to church because of the hypocrites. Well, Pastor, what do you tell them? Well, I tell them this. If God were to come today, did you know those hypocrites are closer to you? I mean, to God, than you are to God? Judge not, lest you be judged. That is what I tell them. So regardless of hypocrisy or a hypocrite, praise God, they're in church. They could be asleep right now. They could be somewhere else right now. They could be careless right now. But we're in church. Come on, somebody. To the religious people, you're not going to like this message. So might as well just close your ears. The word hypocrisy is Greek. Hypokrites. Which is actually used in the meaning of the wearing of masks. In the ancient days, actors would perform. And throughout their performance, they had three masks that they would carry on sticks. You've seen it. Maybe you've gone to a party with a mask. Huh? And one mask is of joy. One mask is of hate, and one mask is of sorrow or sadness. Three steps, three masks, three lives. Happy, hate, sad. So this word hypocrisy is defined as the wearing of masks. There was a man that came to church. It's a story. Not this church or not a man in this church. But this man came to church and he was sitting in church. And then after church, him and his wife, they went to go eat somewhere. And as they journeyed in their vehicle to their place of lunch, all this man did was complain. Didn't get his right parking space. Somebody sat in his chair. The preaching wasn't good enough. The praise and worship didn't touch me. They didn't do a prayer line. I didn't get to talk to the pastor. The pastor didn't look at me when he was talking. All of these complaints. So-and-so didn't shake my hand. I can't believe so-and-so went to church. They were at so-and-so place on Friday night. I mean, just complaining. Everything was wrong. Everyone was guilty minus him. Huh? Everybody had an issue. And he saw it. Yes, sir. Or she, but this story is a man. And so in that vehicle was his little boy. And his wife was just praying for him. Oh, Lord, touch his life. Change him. Break him. They go to eat. They're at a table and they go to the restaurant. They find fellow church members. He had just came out of his car, complaining, griping, talking about everybody. And he goes into this restaurant and he sees the people that were sitting next to him. God bless you, brother. Hallelujah. Wasn't the pastor on fire? Wasn't the praise and worship? Oh, I mean, I'm still feeling it. And here's a little boy, confused. So the little boy asks his dad, Dad, hold on, son. We're going to have to pray for the meal. Oh, most gracious heavenly Father, how marvelous are your works. I so love you today that my family has gathered at the table to partake of the blessings of thy gifts. Bless our pastor. Bless our church. Oh, what a wonderful day in the Lord it has been today. Amen. And the little boy's there with the macaroni and cheese just shaking. So he asked the daddy, Daddy, I got a question for you. Okay, son. Did God hear you complain in the car about the pastor and about the praise and worship and about the parking and about the chair and about the brother that was out there doing this but it was at church on Sunday? Did God hear you complain like that? Well, sure, son, he heard me. Oh, okay. Daddy, I got another question. Okay. Did God just hear you say God bless you to them and say how wonderful church was and how blessed you are and how you can't contain even the tears that are in your eyes because how the praise and worship moved and you prayed for the food so wonderful. Did God hear you pray? Well, sure, son. Well, Daddy, I got another question. Well, what is it, son? Well, which one did God believe? Hmm? The changing of the masks. I know things that set people off immediately. You put on a quick mask to mask the pain and the sorrow that might be going through your life right now. I know people that only know how to mask their life because they fear the opinion of men. I know people today that that's all they've done throughout their life is put on a facade. They've put on a different coat when they're in church or when they're out of church or when they're at home or when they're in their job. I know people like that. You know people like that. So hypocrisy is not new to our world. Hypocrisy is not new to our church. If we read here in the scripture, Jesus Christ pulls it out of the very religious leaders. Come on, somebody. He pulls it out and he points it out to them from the prophecy of Isaiah 400 plus years before this issue happened. See, what happened was the disciples were following Jesus, not the rules of man, not the tradition of man, and not the religious rituals. You see, God gave us 10 commandments, and he gave them to Moses because he knew that Moses needed order for the people. He knew the people could not handle 11. He knew the people couldn't handle 15. He knew the people couldn't handle 20. He just gave them what? 10 laws. He gave it to him and he says, follow these laws and you'll be okay, right? And order was in the house. And people began to walk and march in order. Now from that day until we live today, 600 plus laws, and they keep growing, have been made. Laws that were intentionally to help and better the brethren, but then they got out of hand. They began just to focus on the law and failed to realize why God established his love. The reason why God established thou shalt not worship any other gods before me is because he wanted you to know that he is only the love of your life. Come on. And there is no second God. There is no other God but him. When he said, honor your mother, honor your father, and in honoring your mother and honoring your father, you shall be blessed and live a prosperity life. When he said that, it wasn't for them just to take it for that day and change it when it felt hard for them. Come on, somebody. Or when it just appealed to them. He said it then. He says it now. So hundreds of laws and rules had been made. And this which we just read about the washing of the hands. You see, Jews and Gentiles just didn't get along. It's kind of like religion and relationship. They just don't get along. It's kind of like the judger and the hypocrite. They just don't get along. Come on. Those things just don't get along. And so the disciples following Jesus are now in the marketplace. And now they're eating. And they're eating bread. Bread that was set before them. They said, thank you, Jesus. And they grabbed it and they ate it. No, they did not do their ritual. They didn't do their ceremonial wash. They didn't do what was required of them because the law and the letter says to do this. So here's the Pharisees, religion. The Bible says, and they tried to find fault, huh, What's fault putting to blame? Talking about somebody else. Trying to see somebody else fall. Luke say? Luke says, brother, before you check out the speck that's in my eye, you need to go check out the telephone that's in your own eye. Telephone pole. Let's read a couple of scriptures. Tommy, let's put them on the PowerPoint. Just in the order that I gave them to you. 2 Timothy 3:5, having a form of godliness, but denying its power. And for such people, turn away. Luke 18:11, the Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, God, I thank you that I am not like that other man. Matthew 6:2, therefore, when you do a charitable deed, do not sound a trumpet before you as the hypocrites. This is Jesus saying. As they do in the synagogues and in the streets, and they have glory from men. Assuredly I say to you, they have their reward. Matthew 23:24, talking about our hypocrisy in our finances. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites! For you pay tithe of mint and ain't coming, and have neglected the greater matters of the law, just and mercy and faith. These you ought to have done without leaving the others undone. Blind gates who strain out a gnat and swallow a cane. This is Jesus speaking. Matthew 7:5, he says, hypocrite, first remove the plank from your own eye, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye. Matthew 6:1, take heed that you do not do your charitable deeds before men to be seen just by them. Otherwise, you have no reward from your Father in heaven. Is that it, Tommy, or is there more? There's one more. Beware of the false prophets. Matthew 7:15. Beware of the false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are wolves. I think that's the last. Okay. 1 John 2:4. He who says, I know him and does not keep his, what? He who says, I know him and does not keep his, what? Is a liar. And the truth is not in him. These hypocrites, these religious leaders, these Pharisees, these churchgoers, faithful churchgoers, sought to blame the disciples of Jesus. They wanted to find something against Christ so that they would say, you see, they're not perfect. You see, they cannot be men and women of God. You see, he's not the Son of God, because if he was, he would teach them how to live perfect. And living perfect is staying in the traditions. But Jesus calls them out and says, you say this right now of our unwashed hands, but you're a hypocrite. Because when your parents are of old age, you take everything from them and you tell them, sorry, everything you've gained is mine. You don't give them nothing. Is that honoring your father? Is that honoring your mother? Hypocrites, he calls them. He turns the table and he tells them, who are you to talk to us about our unclean hands? You see, the question is, are we so concerned about our hands that we don't check what's in our hearts? Are we so concerned to wash our hands like Pontius Pilate? That attitude stinks. I have nothing to do with that. Wash my hands, coward.
Remember, as the religious leader, you're not going to like it. You're getting hot right here. I feel it. But I love you, and I'm going to tell you. Coward. They changed their masks. At that time, they put on their religious masks and says, "Woe to you! You didn't wash your hands before you ate. Don't you know you were in the marketplace? Don't you know there were Jews and Gentiles touching you? Don't you know you are ceremonially unclean? You're not worthy to even eat the bread that God provided because you haven't washed your hands." And it wasn't like going to the restroom and putting some Dawn soap and washing your hands. It was washing up, washing down, and washing sideways. It was a ritual. It was more an act. And really the cleansing. And Jesus Christ was saying, before we even need to wash our hands, we got to make sure our heart is washed. Come on. He said, before you're so concerned about what is going inside your mouth, he said, defilement comes from what's coming out. Don't tell me you love me when you don't show me. Come on, somebody. Don't say you're going to help me, but never show up. Come on, somebody. Don't say, well, pastor, when I have, I'll give. And when you have, you never give. Come on. What is Jesus Christ calling us? Put it on the stage. Hypocrite. Hypocrisy. He's not asking you to be perfect. He's just saying, clean your heart. Clean your heart before you use your hands. Come on. The disciples had a pure heart. They gave all, left all, to follow all. Huh? They gave all, left all, to follow all. They didn't need a pat on the back. They didn't need someone to encourage them. They didn't need, nope. All they needed was Christ in them. And I say that to us today. That's all we need. Christ in us, the hope of glory. And what happens to our masks when we're upset and we put on that? Because everyone has those masks. And don't tell me you don't. You put on that mask. Hola, verás. No me saludaron ayer donde estaba yo. Did you hear what? You know what happens? God shatters that masks when you're in Him. When you're in a time of sorrow, suffering, a valley, you want to put on that sad mask. Oh, poor me. Woe to me. Nobody wants to play with me. I brought toys. Nobody wants to play with me. Nobody cares about your toys if your heart's not clean. Nobody wants to know how great God is unless your heart's clean. Their hands can do so much for the kingdom of God, yet if our hearts are not clean, so it's important as we live our life, we got to live and we got to love more. As we live our life, we got to give more. Come on, as we love and live and give our life to Jesus, He begins to take those masks off our life. And the moment I want to pick up that mask of unforgiveness, it's not there no more. Because God replaced it with love and forgiveness. The moment you want to reach for that stab you in the back mask or that complaint or whatever it is. You want to put it on your face so that people can see who you are. God replaced that because you put him first. Same way he told his disciples. You don't understand? You don't understand? I'm telling you. It's not what comes in. It's what comes out. It's what comes out. It's what comes out. It's what comes out that defiles a man. It's what comes out that really tells me who you are. I had a man tell me one day, I could tell if a person's in faith just by spending 1 minute with them. That challenged me to walk and live by faith every time I talk to someone. How do you do that, Pastor? Always see it the way God sees it. Positive. Always put a cross in that. Come on. Always add to that. Come on. Don't leave with subtraction. Just always add with it. But God. Amen. No, pues no podemos porque, but God, si podemos en Cristo. Amen. No, but no, me duele aquí, me duele acá. Sí, pero con Dios todo es posible. Hallelujah. But with God, all things are possible. And maybe you might be hurting right now, but tomorrow's coming. Come on, somebody. But there is a morning. Come on. There is a morning that has a miracle with your name on it. But it's coming. It's coming. It's coming when we have a clean, pure heart. The Bible says in Psalm 24, who can ascend unto the hills of the Lord? Those that have that purity of heart. How can I know I have a pure heart, Pastor? Take off the masks. Be real with yourself. Honor God, love God for who he is, and talk about him. Remember, it's what comes out. It's what comes out. It's what comes out. It's what defiles you. So I declare this church is talking about Jesus more. I declare this church is becoming more like Jesus. Come on. I declare this church is growing more in Jesus. Come on. I'm declaring in the name of Jesus, hypocrites are turning into Christ fits. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm declaring that people that have talked or said, or you're closing their mouths, and you are stirring up warriors in this house and in this church that will move forward with the things of God. We are warriors and we are worshipers of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I'm not ashamed of his name. Come on. And his name is Jesus. Someone say Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise team, why don't y'all get on up here? We're going to play a fast praise song. Amen. Because we're going to leave this church happy. Amen. Someone say happy. All right. Now just change your face. Say happy. Thank you, Jesus. Amen and amen. And we're going to stay happy, church. Amen. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Amen. Wherever we go, we know that his joy, his love is with us. And so, thank you for hearing my heart, amen, on the ministry. Now, there's more. This might continue on Wednesday or until the Lord leads. There's a whole lot more. I didn't even read what was ministered to as the sermon. I just ministered out of my heart. But there's so much to know about our life and our love in Christ Jesus. And we have to do it with a pure heart. A pure heart. I spoke to some men that were working, and I love it. I love it because they are serving the Lord from a pure heart. They're not asking for anything. People can always ask for something. But these individuals, and I say this to honor the service unto the Lord, because they're not asking for anything. They're doing it with their whole heart. And you know what happens when God sees heart? Huh? Come on, somebody. He says, you're going to have your reward. You're going to have your reward. God bless them. God bless them. There'll be a day they'll have a concrete truck come to their house and say, hey, I heard you needed concrete. They're going to be like, I did? Well, sure, you sowed a seed. Come on, somebody. And now we got trucks for you. Come on, somebody. Amen. That's how God works. When you sow, you reap. When you sow,
You reap. Someone say, when I sow, come on. I reap. Come on, say, I sow. Come on. I reap. Hallelujah. And there's a blessing of the Lord that's upon this church. He has supernaturally provided rams. And I say plural because there are people here in this house that will continue to sow sacrificially, continue to give from the abundance of their life, continue to give even what they have. Because when we sow, come on, we reap. Come on. Because when we sow, come on, we reap. I had a conversation with an individual and they said, Pastor, we've never would have started this construction. The pastor wouldn't have been able to come and bless us with the ceiling. If we would never have started, then Tommy and Jesse and those that are serving would not be able to have their location to serve the Lord Jesus Christ with their heart. Or areas of faith for our team to sit. Pastor, if I didn't get started with the forms out there, then that one person that purchased the truck of concrete wouldn't have had the opportunity to sow that seed. You see, when we move, God moves. Amen? And church, we're moving. Come on, somebody. We're moving. Someone say, we are? Hallelujah. That's right. We're moving. We're not staying here. Come on, church. We're not staying here. This is temporary. We're passing through. But as we're passing through, we have to be faithful and be blessed by what He's sown and given to us. Because to much is given, much is required. If you're faithful with little, God said, I'll bless you with the much. How are we going to believe God for that 100x100 multiplex church slab if we can't be faithful to have 100 feet? Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. So as we start, He continues to give. So as you surrender your love offering today, I'm going to ask our ushers to please bring our offering baskets here to the middle. I'm going to ask you to pray and to ask the Lord, what is my part? By faith, we've called trucks to come in to pour concrete. By faith, we're declaring in the name of Jesus, those trucks are paid for. By faith, we are declaring that we have started and we know the Lord will always complete. And Father, you're touching and speaking to the lives that are here in this church and that will be a part of this seed. And they will sow and they will reap in the name of Jesus. So we bless every tither. As we know that the tithe belongs to you, my tenth, without question, belongs to you. It is yours and it is holy. I'm not a thief. We are not thieves. Come on. Malachi says, if you don't give, you're a robber. You're a thief. No, we are not thieves. We are givers. We give according to your word. We understand that it is in your word that you rebuke the devourer, not some man rebuking it. It is Almighty God as we surrender our tithe. And as we give in our offerings, we know the work of God is given. They asked the disciples, well, do y'all pay tax? Do y'all pay Caesar? And Jesus Christ said, go fishing, son. And out of that first fish, you're going to find a coin. Give to God what is God's. Give to man what they need. But God will always be blessed. So I declare our offerings supernaturally overflowing with the blessings of God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Before we sow, 2 nights ago I woke up at about 3 o'clock. And I walked those forms right there. Dirt was all unleveled. Really, there wasn't completed work, but it was on its way. And I walked it
with my chanclas and I was just in shorts. It was cold, but I was out there just walking. And church, I saw hundreds and thousands of feet and footprints all on those sidewalks. And I saw them fellowshipping. I saw them turning. I saw them loving. I saw others praying. I just saw them coming into the house of God. And I saw lines of trucks with those concrete. And all of them had a smile. They were waving. I don't know if you've been down Guadalupe. Our school is so blessed, and every day we're seeing construction, and our children need it. And I say, yes, do it for the children and the students. And you see those concrete trucks coming in. You see those steel buildings coming in. You see those recreational centers coming in, and construction is just down the road. Come on, somebody. He put us in this place, and he's preparing the place. Come on, somebody. You go down Martinez Street all the way, there's construction. Come on, somebody. Our city's blessed. Someone say our city's blessed. Come on. And I saw that arrow just pointing at Grace Acres. And he said, son, be faithful. Keep challenging the people. Keep giving them vision. It's on its way. And I said, thank you, Jesus. He said, but be faithful with these sidewalks. You be faithful with them, it'll keep coming. And I said, thank you, Jesus. So by faith, we've asked people to help and support. So if that's you and you want to help us and you want to be a part of this river, because Miss Kim, I saw angels writing names. All those footprints. And then at the end of the day, he went back to a record and he says, okay, Sister Elia gave to the concrete those hundreds of thousands of footsteps on her record. Okay, Sister Elia gave. She prayed. She sowed. She brought some homemade tortillas. All those footprints. Come on, somebody. And then I saw us in heaven rejoicing in the Lord. And I saw a line outside your mansion, Sister Elia. Not anytime soon. But I saw a line outside your mansion. And you opened the door and you saw a line of people. He said, yes. He says, the sidewalks. We just wanted to say thank you. Come on, church. He's building his church. Amen. And the gates of hell shall not prevail. He's building his church. And not just a church of walls, but he's building the house of God. He's building it for people. He's building it so that the people will be encouraged of the Lord. So today, with a pure heart, reap today the blessings of the Lord. Come now and release the seed of faith. Bless the work of the Lord. Hallelujah. We call it blessed right now in the mighty name of Jesus.
Through you the blind will see. Through you the new will see. Through you the dead will rise.
say, I'm free. Come on, I'm free in the name of Jesus.
I am free. Yes. I am free to run.
Come on.
I am free. I am free to dance.
Let's bless our offering today and let's declare it fruitful as it has been sown into the hands of God. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this offering. We bless your name and we thank you, Lord, for, oh, just the beginnings of our commitment to you, Lord God, wholeheartedly. With a pure heart, Father, we sow and we thank you, Lord God, for lives changed, rearranged, and the blessings of the Lord on this seed in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen.
Amen.
Come on, everyone said amen.
Amen.
Say it again, say amen.
Amen.
Let me hear you say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say it again.
Hallelujah.
Say it in Spanish. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Say it in English.
Hallelujah.
Say it in Japanese.
Hallelujah.
How about heavenese? God is good, amen, and he's good all the time. Come on, give him a great hand clap. We love you, Jesus. Tonight, we have service at 6 o'clock. Spanish service. I want to invite everybody to come. It'll be our last Spanish service during the afternoon. And 2016, here we go. Every 9:30 service will be a bilingual full service. Powerful praise, powerful worship, powerful prayer, powerful ministry. In every service, come on, to God be the glory. Praying for our young adults,
amen.
Praying for our young people,
amen.
Praying for our children, praying for Master's Commission, Abigail Ministries, just praying for everybody, amen. To God be the glory. Pastor Kim, I want to greet and love on the Ramon family. If you can bring them here, I want to love on them. And then Tiffany, get on up here. And Eloy, put that beautiful guitar down because you're going to be holding a baby soon. Thank you, Jesus. So I want the church to love on them. And I'm going to ask the Gonzalez family to please come also. And I want to just love on everybody. Amen. Happy birthday, Jesus. We'll see you tonight at 6. We'll see you Wednesday at 7. And we'll definitely see you on Sunday. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful, wonderful Sunday celebration.
Through you the blind will see. Through you the mute will see. Through you the dead will rise. Through you our heart will praise. Through you the darkness flee. Through you my heart sing. I am free. Dance. I am free to dance. I am free to live for you. I am free to live for you. I am free. I am free. 'Cause we are free to run. Cause we are